time since joining Coventry as player-manager Terry Butcher has left himself out. Butcher takes a seat on the sidelines, having picked a team to do a job, and that job is to become the first side in 3 years to beat Nottingham Forest in this competition. It's an adventurous lineup with attacking midfielder David Smith and striker Steve Livingstone both restored to the side, and a change of tactics from the three-man central defence that Butcher favoured in his first two games in charge. Forest, who haven't lost in this competition since being beaten by Manchester City in October 1987, are unchanged tonight. It's the third successive season they've played Coventry in this competition, and they won on both previous occasions. The referee, Mr. Roger Pawley from Cambridge. So Nottingham Forest get the game underway in a competition they really relish. They've been in five finals in the last 12 seasons and have won the trophy the last 2 years. But Forest's recent form is patchy, with only one win from their last six league games. A perfect night for football, cold and crisp, and the pitch looking in superb condition here. Harker with a long ball forward, but Steve Ogrizovic had no problem gathering for Coventry City. Forest, of course, in the red shirts and white shorts. Coventry City in the blue and white stripes. Another fierce kick from Ogrizovic, beating everybody apart from Walker, who covered well. But his header drops to Smith, and Edwards supporting him down the left. Walker met the cross, and it was difficult then for Forest. And the combination of Walker, Laws and Chettle finally forced the ball behind for Coventry's first corner kick. Just out of the picture at the moment, Billing, the big centre-half, has come forward. There he is, number five, Regis. Also a possible target here. It goes into the near post, in fact. Oh, it's off the line, it's in! Gallagher hits the rebound home, and Coventry City are in front! Delight for Highfield Road, 15 minutes gone, and Kevin Gallagher was so sharp in the penalty area then, when it looked as though Coventry had missed their chance to score. Lovely flick on from Livingstone. The downward header from Speedie was cleared off the line, but Gallagher was quicker than anyone onto the rebound. Forest will want to know why Speedie was left unmarked in the first place. A vital goal for Kevin Gallagher, his third in the competition this season, his fifth in all. And Coventry City lead the holders Nottingham Forest by 1-0. And Regis with another good header forward for Livingstone. Pearce did well though, that was really classy defending by the England number three. Billing's clearance, Speedie, who's really fired up to play well here today, involved again. Now Regis in space in the middle. Good ball too, and Gallagher's got three again. Oh, what a goal! Two in the space of a minute for Kevin Gallagher. And I can't believe it here at Coventry. But Mark Crossley and the Nottingham Forest goal must take the lion's share of the blame for this. The ball was played out to Gallagher, and I'm sure that Crossley was expecting a centre to the far post, because he seemed to get himself completely in the wrong position. Maybe that's what was intended. Whatever, it was a bad goalkeeping error. Well, the 21-year-old who's played every game this season since displacing Steve Sutton will be very disappointed with that goal. I think no words are needed for that particular picture. Well, Forest absolutely stunned by that, and they've got a lot of hard work to do now just to get back into this game, as Edwards plays it high to the edge of the box, cleared, and Speedie with the first time shot. Well, whatever Terry Butcher said to fire David Speedie up, it's worked. He's started this game in magnificent form. Looking ball for Jensen, but Billing saw the danger and did well then. And then into trouble with Keane. Burrows helped him out. Another good kick from Ogrizovic. Sheffield meets it this time. Laws onto it for Nottingham Forest. Parker alongside him. Looking for Crosby down the right, and it was a good ball. Edwards quickly over to cover again. Crosby twisting and turning at the fullback. And eventually getting a good cross in, and it beats everybody but Keane. And Ogrizovic saves it at the second attempt as Hodge came sliding in. Did well then, big Steve Ogrizovic. And young Roy Keane, who's only scored one goal for Nottingham Forest, and it was in this competition against Burnley, very close to pulling Forest back into the picture then. A difficult shot sliding along the wet top. It's a very long kick once more from Ogrizovic. Shackle having to shepherd it forward as Livingstone came in and tackled him. Shackle complaining about the challenge, I think. But it's Coventry's throw. 18 minutes of the first half remaining here, and Coventry City lead the League Cup holders, Nottingham Forest, by 2-0. Walker getting in ahead of Regis. Chattel's long clearance picked up by Billing on the halfway line. And Coventry are playing some good football here, marking tight, tackling ferociously, and going forward with some style, as Burrows proves. Overdid it a little bit, but Speedie make sure Coventry keep possession. Billing's long ball onto the head of Livingstone, and he nearly set Gallagher free again. And it comes back to Gallagher as the two defenders got in each other's way, and Livingstone has made it three! It's a demolition job, this. 17 minutes to half-time, and astonishingly, Coventry City are 3-0 in front, and Nottingham Forest are in total disarray. Steve Livingstone scores for the third time in the competition this season, and his sixth goal in all, and the man who made a name for himself with four goals in last season's competition against Sunderland has made a very, very good platform now for Coventry City to go on to the quarter-finals. Pearce. Boos from the fans who used to cheer him here. Clough. And the sharp rebound, it's straight against the defender. Chettle still forward. Clough! Has it gone in? No. Referee had a good long look at it. Clough appealed for goal, for play on, says the referee. And it's not Nottingham Forest night so far. Keane in possession for them, though. Jemson. Hackett comes to Hodge. What an astonishing first half this is proving to be. Regis. And Coventry counter-attack again with Burrows. Gallagher. Speedie. Regis. Burrows. Good stuff from Coventry City. Still Burrows, dispossessed in the end by Hodge, and Pearce swept it back to Crossley. Well, we can look at this one again as it was pulled back by Chettle, Clough clipping it. It hit the underside of the bar and bounced down. The referee said no goal. Nigel Clough threw his arms up in the air, being convinced that he'd scored, but no goal given. Smith. Edwards. The interception by Parker. It was a bit awkward in possession, and he was dispossessed by Smith. And a lot of Coventry players forward again here. He looked for Regis on the far post. And a spectacular clearance by Pearce. And I think that showed the kind of pressure Forest are under here. But Pearce didn't feel he was able to take any risk at all then. Goes into Regis on the near post. Dealt with awkwardly again. Billing coming in there. Oh, and it's turned forward. First half this has been, and Crossley has been beaten four times. Billings, little header forward, creating the danger, and that spectacular shot by Gallagher. But once again, Nottingham Forest defensively, you have to ask all kinds of questions about them. The ball wriggling through the man on the line. Gallagher gets his hat-trick. Coventry get their four. Coventry City four. Nottingham Forest nil. This must be the most astonishing 45 minutes between two first division teams all season. And Gallagher in possession again, finding Livingstone. Gynn borrows. Regis. Parker takes it from him. Play on, says the referee. This is Keane. Jemson. Turned on by Clough. A lovely ball. Parker. Crosby. They're shell-shocked here, Nottingham Forest. They need a goal now from Clough, and they've got one. Dear, dear, will there be any end to the scoring in the first half? There's still 9 minutes to go to half-time. 4-1. And if that goal had come a little bit earlier, Nottingham Forest might have felt that they were in with a shout. They still will feel that. Good effort by Clough into the corner, beating Ogrizovic. Hit very deliberately. His fourth goal of the season and his third in the last four games. Now Clough again. Good ball for Crosby. Peake knocking it forward. Offside, offside. Livingston's gone on, but I think he knew the whistle had gone. Walker's kick. Jemson's having his shirt tugged. The play on, says the referee, and Hodge suddenly in possession. Ogrizovic with a good save. Hodge is still there. Jemson going up, but Ogrizovic is a big man. He'll do well to beat him in the air, and suddenly Coventry counter-attack again. What an amazing cut tie this is. Livingstone. Parker. And Crosby. Good tackle by Edwards. And you can see here that shot saved well by Ogrizovic with his legs from Hodge. Jemson, Hodge. Bad ball from Hodge. Peake heads it away, but still it comes back to Crosby. Jemson, Pierce. Parker's still there. Now Keane. Threaded through beautifully for Clough. Pierce with the shot. It was on the wrong foot for him, wasn't it? If that had fallen to his left foot, Nottingham Forest might have really felt they were back in the game. Threaded through by Keane. Clough couldn't find space for a shot himself. Set it up for Pierce, but his right's nowhere near as good as his left. Jemson running intelligently into space. Edwards was across to cover him. He kept possession well then. Crosby did really well with the cross. Very clear by Gynn. Parker. Speedie gets it away to Regis. And given away again sloppily by Nottingham Forest, but then Coventry commit the same sin. Here goes Pierce. Hodge. Hodge had nowhere to go. Good covering by Coventry. Jemson gets it back to him again, and a good ball for Clough. Unbelievable, it's another goal. Clough second, Nottingham Forest second, the sixth of the half, with 3 minutes still to play in the end of, to the interval. It's now Coventry four, Nottingham Forest two. What a beautiful finish that was by Nigel Clough. Absolute quality here. He saw the gap and he hit the ball sweetly, virtually along the ground, into the corner of the net. Ogrizovic beaten. Lovely build-up between Jemson and Hodge. Clough got himself into space and finished magnificently. Well, only a few minutes ago it looked as though Nottingham Forest were dead and buried, but not now. Two superb strikes by Nigel Clough have given them hope, albeit a glimmer. What a half. Six goals and a few other near misses. Great stuff here at Highfield Road. I'm not sure he's really enjoyed it though. Gallagher. And Forrester got their tails up suddenly. Keane. Pierce with the cross. Could have gone anywhere and still could. Now the linesman has flagged that he's given a goal. Crosby has bundled it over the line. Well, somebody got the final touch anyway, and the linesman on the far side flagged goal, and Nottingham Forest have pulled it back to 4-3. Unbelievable. Two minutes to half time, and the incredible has happened here. Ogrizovic missing it, and Crosby couldn't quite get the touch, or did he? It was either him or Clough, it matters not to Nottingham Forest. 4-3, seven goals in the first 44 minutes. Oh, Nigel Clough and his dad have never been involved in a game like this, I would think. Here's Keane, and they're looking for an equaliser now, isn't it unbelievable? They just want to slow it down now, Coventry, I would have thought. Burrows. And there's the half-time whistle. And this is one that the Coventry City and Nottingham Forest fans at Highfield Road will remember for a very, very long time. Two first-half hat-tricks. One for Kevin Gallagher. One for Nigel Clough. Seven goals, an absolutely amazing 45 minutes cup football here. At the end of it all, Coventry City lead Nottingham Forest, the holders, by 4-3. What, I wonder, is in store in the second half? Coventry City get the second half underway, having been 4-0 up, now finding themselves clinging on to a single goal advantage. And I just wonder what Terry Butcher must have said to them at half-time. No managerial preparation in the world could get you ready for a first half like that. Foul on Jensen by Peake. Terry Butcher in the rather unusual managerial dugout here at Highfield Road. That's more like a trench. Pierce with the early free kick then for Nottingham Forest. Well taken by Chettle. With good covering by Burrows, and he slid it very deliberately towards Ogrizovic as Clough came in. Regis winning it in the air again, but nobody to profit from his downward header. And Pierce forced into a hurried clearance. Coventry have the throw. Gallagher in possession. Brought down right beneath the gaze of the referee. Pierce angrily remonstrating with Mr. Pawley, but the referee could hardly have been better placed to decide then. His feet. Burrows and Smith, the two Coventry City players who might fancy a shot on the target here. Gynn is over the ball as well. It's Burrows who hits it. That was close enough to give Nottingham Forest a few heartaches again. At one stage this season, Brian Burrows was leading scorer here at Highfield Road. He's got four goals, and that was a fine effort. It cleared, Speedie onto it. Burrows under pressure from Keane, and the Irishman's got away with the ball. Forest pouring players forward in support. He went a bit too far. Now the referee gets in the act. It's all happening tonight. Punch. Good ball. Parker into space, and he's lost his marker well, and hit it. Of the first half remaining are now level. 8 minutes into the second half, Coventry pay the price for indecisive defensive work, and a fine shot by Parker makes it 4-4. Steve Ogrizovic, I'm sure, will be unhappy about that one sneaking in on the near post. Parker's second goal of the season, both of them in this competition, and now anybody could go on and win this game. A four-goal lead has been thrown away by Coventry City. Forest are really hunting down Coventry players when they're in possession. Here's Burrows. That's a lovely little ball for Gynn. He's got Regis in the middle, Gallacher on the right. It comes back. Oh! It's a spectacular clearance in the end from Laws. His heart must have been in his mouth, though, and the ball looped goalwards. Well, New Regis was behind him, and he had to get the contact. Corner. Over Regis's head. He played it in towards the far post. Regis again. Has it gone in? And finally forcing the ball in, and Coventry City are back in front. The scramble in the goal mouth. Regis caused the danger with the shot forward as it rebounded out again. It was Livingstone who reacted quickest with a header. His second goal of the game. Regis caused the trouble with that shot. Laws sliced it clear, but Livingstone forced it in. Regis. Edwards. Walker chasing here because Gallagher was coming in quickly, and the young goalkeeper did well then. Peake's header. Keane won it. This is Pierce. He'll have a shot from here if he's given the opportunity. He wasn't, because he was brought down by Livingstone, and that could be a dangerous position in which to concede a free kick against Nottingham Forest, as Pierce will probably pick himself up and take it, and might fancy his chances from here. Although Nigel Clough is another who I have seen score some spectacular free kick goals from this range. Pierce blockbuster, and Ogrizovic palmed it away. Tremendous effort from Stuart Pierce. Regis couldn't keep that one in, and Pierce denied by a good save from Ogrizovic. I wonder he's quite big, his hands. They're probably stinging after that shot on a cold night. Gloves or no gloves. And the Nottingham Forest bench and Brian Clough have been around for a long time in this game, but I doubt that they've encountered many matches like this. Regis did well then for Coventry. This is Smith. Fouled by Laws. Edwards curling it in towards Speedie. A good little downward header for Smith. It took a deflection for a corner. otherwise it could well have gone in. Beautiful header by Speedie to set up Smith from the free kick by Edwards. Deft little header from the Scottish international. Smith struck it with some power and the deflection took it away from danger. Corner it is though. Long towards Speedie on the far post. Oh, Walker just virtually took it off his head. Burrows. Gallagher. It's done well. It's done splendidly. And wins the corner. To the end of this pulsating cup tie. 9 goals, 5 of them for Coventry, 4 for Nottingham Forest. Coventry with the corner. Regis with the downward header. Burrows goes in, but Pierce comes out with the ball. And a good ball too to Jemson. Crosby. It looks dangerous. Jemson! Oh! That was the golden opportunity for Nottingham Forest to snatch it again. 2 minutes remaining. It was set up perfectly for Nigel Jemson to equalise. Just wide. Peake's tackle. Livingstone. Dispossessed. But as long as the ball stays in the Forest half, Coventry know they're all right. Livingstone now, turned in towards Regis, oh, he could have clinched it for sure then, but didn't get the header right, and Crossley immediately gets it downfield. Jemson couldn't control it. Gynn is in there with Keane. It's a Forest throw. 47 and a half minutes on my watch, the referee has looked at his. With Brian Clough's grip on the League Cup finally shaken off. 9 goals. Livingstone got what proved to be the winner, his second goal of the game. 2 players got hat-tricks, Kevin Gallagher for Coventry and Nigel Clough for Nottingham Forest, and Terry Butcher has earned a famous victory in only his 3rd game in charge as player-manager. He sat it out tonight, but my goodness, he inspired his side to a quite incredible win. The final score at Highfield Road, Coventry City 5, Nottingham Forest 4, and the winners of this competition for the last 2 seasons are out.
Terry, your first win as a manager, but what a way to start.
Yeah, I mean, it was quite an exciting cup tie.
Quite an exciting cup tie. It was a sensational cup tie, really.
Well, I think if every game's like that, I'll either be grey or bald at the time I'm 33. But no, it's great. It's great for the fans that we've scored 5 goals. Obviously, not so good that we've let in 4. But it was a rip roarer anyway. And I think anybody who was neutral in the crowd got their money's worth tonight.
Going into that game, Nottingham Forest, cup holders for the last 2 years in this competition, unbeaten for 22 games. I mean, that looked very formidable for you, didn't it?
Well, it proved tonight that they are great cup fighters. They have got a great record in this competition, and they were obviously determined not to relinquish the trophy very easily. And to be 4-0 down, they just gave it a go, and all credit to them for coming back to 4-4. And but even at 4-4, I still fancied our team to do well, and you know, towards the end, it could have been either way. But we're obviously pleased. The lads are delighted, and we're in the hat again.
Why did you not play yourself?
Well, various reasons. I took this game on its own merit because it was a cup tie, because we had to get at Forest and obviously had to score some goals. And I just reverted to the back four. Perhaps I'm getting a little bit older than the tooth or whatever, or it was a decision that I felt was the right for the team anyway. So it was just one of those things.
Are you going to carry on playing? I mean, are you going to play on Saturday?
Well, I mean, if we win 5-4 on Saturday, playing the way we have done without me, then I'll sit at the bench. I'm happy to do that.